I'm going to replace my suspension, the shock absorbers, also the control arms, and I want to use genuine shock absorbers. I had aftermarket ones, such Bodge, whatnot, Moro, so on. I wasn't satisfied, but I want to put a genuine one. So what happens is that this is the plate, identification plate for the car. It's located on the left side under the hood for some years, and I think it's located, let me just see, on other markets, maybe in Europe, it would be on the right rear door on the B pillar somewhere, but for this car, this is a 2003. I just want to show a little bit how to read this plate, because we have this code here, this long number. This is the code, it contains the codes for the suspension parts. Why I'm saying this, because if you look in the aftermarket struts, front shock absorbers, you'll find there's just one single option for each brand, maybe a Sach or a Bodge or Bilstein, one single option for all years, for 2001-2009. But if you look to the Volvo side, Volvo tells you that for 2001-2009 there has been 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different shock absorbers, different numbers. And if you want to put genuine ones, you need to select the right one for your car. So I will link this page, I'll put it in the comment section below. I'll put a few links, this page to a link how to read the plate. Oops, windy a bit. Let me just show you on my car how to select the right shock absorber. So I found this page on IPD USA, but there are other sites which show it. Sometimes there are errors on it, so I'll just try to correct the errors. This is a 2002 and a half and up, so it shows you these numbers here and what's the meaning. But like I said, look, my corrections here, it's just not okay, and this site seems to be copy one each other, so they repeat the same error on other sites. But if you look at this number here, it has several digits and letters, and it says it contains the codes for a front shock absorber, the genuine one. If you need also to that's the strut shock absorber, also to order a spring, also to order anti-sway bar, because it had different thickness depending on the model, turbo, non-turbo, maybe the R model also. So yeah, there have been several variations depending on the trim, again, year, and the turbo, non-turbo. Because I guess what happens is that on some models, this is the base model, non-turbo, not, it's not, doesn't have the turbo piping. It came with 15 and 16 inches welds, but the turbo ones had bigger welds, 16, 17, even 18. So I guess the shock absorber, just my theory, or the spring, it's different size, small, slightly different size, slightly different gap here to allow for bigger welds on the turbo models. That's why I guess there have been many variations. And also the damping rate may be different on turbo models, which have more powerful engines. Just a theory, but it's really worth understanding that there are different shock absorbers. And I can tell you something, I put the aftermarket, like you see here, Volvo had different variations, but the aftermarket have only one choice. And I put the aftermarket on my non-turbo car, and I always get the front of the car lifted by maybe half an inch or so. So I got three brands different, and all the time it's lifting. I don't think it's because it's a new shock or stuff like that. And that's why I want to get the genuine one, so I don't have any longer problems with the height on the front suspension. And also one thing, you notice there, mostly people will recommend get the Sach aftermarket one. And also quite a few people think the Sach is exactly the same as genuine. Well, it's obvious the Sach is the company that did the genuine for Volvo. It's a stamped Volvo and Sach on the sticker, on the original part. But I don't think they put the same quality parts inside the shock in their aftermarket option compared to the genuine one. I don't think it's the same quality. At least I tested and the ride is not the same quality at all, especially in the poor pavements. And one other thing is, if you look for such, if you check FCP Euro, IPD USA, you want to purchase such aftermarket one, they sell for $95. If you look for the genuine one, it's $105. It's really 10 extra dollars and you get the original quality of the suspension. So I honestly don't understand why would you buy a just save $10 and get the cheaper such parts. That's just my point. It's really just a $10 difference because Volvo has dropped their prices lately. I put also in the comment section a site where I'll show you the prices for this, and I put one for the US market, one for the Canadian market as well. So my number, it's the lower one and this is the codes, and it says 20 it's for the spring hold, 21 it's for the front strut code. This is just an example, it's not your car, so I need to get the third and fourth digit here. So my code will be for the shock absorber 11, the front one. And when I look to the Volvo site, the genuine ones, I think it's there, right there. So this is my shock absorber. My part is just for my car. This is the part number. You can go purchase the genuine one and you are going to have the original suspension. And I can tell you, because I had a Budge which is very close to the original one, it's completely different than such. There is just no comparison in softness, responsiveness, handling, stability. It's just the original one has really a Volvo feeling, which I could not find in even newer such replacement. But that's just my feeling is subjective a little bit. So again, this is the part, the code for your suspension. There are other numbers here. This is the color of the car. This is the interior trim. This is the market. This is Canada. You got the VIN number. You got the chassis number, are the last six digits, not this small symbol, but just the last six digits. That's the chassis number. So this is it. And I also recommend you get control arms. I will get genuine Volvo bushings, buying from the main dealer as well, online, not from the location itself. Online is much cheaper, and I will replace my control arms. So this was it. Sorry for the longer video, but I really recommend you get the genuine replacement. Some people also like Bilstein, maybe Bilstein before, but Bilstein is stiffer, so if you have poor roads, it's not the best options. Thanks for watching, guys, and thanks for the patience.